takes a very particular kind of man to be Taylor Swift's boyfriend, and I think she has found perhaps the perfect match in Travis.
Touchdown to Kelce.
You telling me Taylor Swift is going to become the driving force of the Kansas City Chiefs to win the Super Bowl? What? Commit me.
And now, speculation about their future together has reached a fever pitch.
If he doesn't mess it up, this is endgame.
Can you imagine what kind of children they would have if they had a son? He could probably play in a Super Bowl ultimately and do the halftime show.
So why does this relationship work when the others didn't?
I think she is letting him be the alpha.
TMZ investigates Taylor and Travis, ultimate love story.
There are it couples, and then there's Taylor Swift and Travis Kelce.
It's worldwide, man. It's worldwide. It's been magnified for sure, though.
Their relationship has mesmerized the globe.
How about more of Taylor Swift and Travis Kelce?
Can't get enough.
Can't get enough.
Taylor-san なんですけど、アメリカンフットボールの有名選手。
Popkönigin Taylor Swift und Footballspieler Travis Kelce.
Swift habló sobre su romance con el jugador de fútbol americano Travis Kelce.
One big reason why. Just about everyone is into them because they're into each other.
They're both in love, and they're both really enjoying the benefits that their two worlds are bringing to each other that they didn't have access to prior to falling in love.
First of all, yep. Travis Kelce has to marry Taylor Swift.
Lots of people looking from the outside in say, this one's headed for the altar.
Over the shoulder, Taylor.
If he doesn't mess it up, she won't mess it up. But if he doesn't mess it up, this is endgame.
I think they're going to get married, and I think they're going to have kids.
It seems like someone would be hard-pressed to find a better, at least surface-level match for Taylor Swift.
To understand why this relationship seems to work, you have to understand them, where they came from, their families, their goals, their values. There are differences for sure, but those differences actually explain how Taylor and Travis complement each other in a very unique way.
It's equal balance on both playing fields. Neither one can be intimidated by the other because they're not in each other's field, but yet they're supporting each other.
You look beautiful today, Miss Taylor.
Thanks. Get off the dome. Good. Good.
Travis and Taylor were born exactly 69 days apart. Travis in October, Taylor in December, 1989. Both are from solid middle-class families, and both were raised in small towns. Taylor in Wyomissing, Pennsylvania, and Travis in Cleveland Heights, Ohio.
Trav, you get the kickoff. Jason kicks it, you get the run.
Yay, Taylor.
They both showed signs of greatness early on. Taylor landed her first record deal at age 15 and had a hit single when she was still in high school.
Our song is a slam of screen doors, sneaking LA, tapping on your window when we're on the phone and you talk real slow because it's late and your mama don't know.
Usually when I'm at school, a song will just pop into my head. Sitting there in class and getting a melody and lyrics just coming to you and you're just like, oh, God. And I'll pull out my cell phone and make a voice memo and people think I'm crazy.
That work ethic has never wavered.
She's heading up a really big business for a long time now, and I think that's brought a lot of maturity along the way too. So you can't be naive and do that kind of thing successfully in a sustained way.
Taylor Swift is one of the hardest working individuals on the planet. I think she's a marketing genius. She has insisted on being in the driver's seat from the very beginning of her career.
As for Travis, he excelled at three sports in high school, baseball, basketball.
Travis Kelce got off to a 4-0 start.
I can get a little shots outside. I just play wherever I get the ball.
And of course, football.
1,523 yards as a senior.
Never seen anything like it.
But there were differences. Taylor was a straight-A student in high school and finished in just 3 years so she could focus on music.
Watch me strike a match, I'm on my way to stick up. Please, you haven't heard, you're just another picture to find.
Travis, well, school wasn't really his thing.
I ended up failing French, and I couldn't play my sophomore year of football.
A nominee tonight for Female Vocalist of the Year, Taylor Swift.
She sold out Madison Square Garden in 1 minute. Ladies and gentlemen, Taylor Swift.
This is my first Grammy, you guys.
Moon Man for Best Female Video goes to Taylor Swift.
Taylor Swift!
Taylor Swift, Megan Travis and Taylor Swift.
As Taylor was setting the music world on fire, Travis was burning up the gridiron at the University of Cincinnati.
How's it feel, 18? How's it feel?
Feel right! Number one! Let's go!
In his sophomore year, he helped the Bearcats secure a slot in the Sugar Bowl until he was busted for weed.
I partied a little too much down there, got hit with a drug test, and from that point on, I realized I got a tight.
But that was just a speed bump. As we all know, Travis went on to achieve football greatness.
If you ain't gonna go out there giving your all, I don't want you in Washington!
Hands it off to Wynn, who throws a jump pass caught by Kelce. What a brilliant play! It is caught by Travis Kelce, flying down the sideline at the 20, the 10, touchdown!
The Kansas City Chiefs select Travis Kelce.
Turning out hit after hit after hit. The more famous she got, the more the public watched her every move, especially when it came to her romances.
Having the world treat my love life like a spectator sport in which I lose every single game was not a great way to date in my teens and 20s. But it taught me to protect my private life fiercely.
There is sort of an abnormal magnifying glass, like telescope lens on everything that happens between me and anybody else.
Right?
I don't really know that much about love, it turns out.
She's never met anyone that wasn't intimidated by her or didn't want something out of it. That's my opinion. She's Taylor Swift and no one has pursued her. She never had love. Yeah, she had great content to write music on, but she didn't have that endgame lover.
We all know Taylor has literally made a career singing about failed romances, but it's clearly been painful for her. Finding long-lasting love seemed elusive. She said at times it felt hopeless, and Travis wasn't having much luck either. To understand how they came together, you gotta understand why their other relationships fell apart.
I think that people do learn from every relationship. And just because a relationship doesn't end with you holding each other's hand on the Titanic does not mean that it was a failure.
I think that Taylor has probably done a lot of work on herself, a lot of reflection, someone who's looked at a lot of the relationships that she's been in. We've seen some of that introspection in the songs that she's written.
My name is Travis Kelce, and I'm looking for love.
And a lot of people are like, oh, screwed over his last girlfriend. Well, you know what? People go from people to people till they find the one. That's life.
Who says you can't get everything?
Taylor Swift and Travis Kelce seem like a perfect fit. And one big reason is they've achieved their success in different universes.
I love success, and you got two successful people here. Both of them are happy, both of them are achievers, and they seem really happy for each other's success. There seems to be no envy, no jealousy, and they're both just cheerleaders for the other one.
Finding each other was a long and winding road for both Taylor and Travis. They each went through relationships that mostly ended badly, but each failed relationship was a building block for the future.
I think that people do learn from every relationship. And just because a relationship doesn't end with you holding each other's hand on the Titanic does not mean that it was a failure in a relationship. Hopefully, you've learned something from each relationship.
Taylor's chronicled her relationships in song, and she paints a picture of a young woman who has burned many times over.
That's a message for Jake Gyllenhaal, for all of the world to hear. They dated in 2010 for just a few months. Was I out of line? Joe Jonas had broken her heart just 2 years earlier.
When I find that person that is right for me and is he'll be wonderful, and when I look at that person, I'm not even going to be able to remember the boy who broke up with me over the phone in 25 seconds when I was 18.
Her relationship with John Mayer hit the skids after less than a year. The age disparity was eyebrow-raising. He was 32 and she was 19.
As the years ticked by, more relationships, more breakups, and of course, more breakup songs. 'Cause I knew you were trouble when you walked in. So shame on me now, blew me to places I've never been. Till you put me down. She writes these amazing love songs and why it goes wrong. And she's probably working out, that didn't work, that didn't work. She's an incredibly smart woman. Business savvy and creatively. She's knowing that this is her therapy, and if I end up doing it right and figuring it out, I'm gonna have true love in the end.
Well, true love proved elusive. She ended a 6-year relationship with Joe Alwyn in 2023, and the breakup was bitter. Our Taylor sources say he just couldn't handle her success. Taylor's upcoming album, The Tortured Poets Department, is all about Joe. Embrace yourself. One of the songs is titled, The Smallest Man Who Ever Lived.
It's very hard to find a decent guy that isn't intimidated by your success. I think a lot of men have trouble dealing with it.
Taylor has indeed been introspective about her failed relationships and her search for the right man.
I think that Taylor has probably done a lot of work on herself, a lot of reflection, someone who's looked at a lot of the relationships that she's been in. We've seen some of that introspection in the songs that she's written.
If Travis Kelce's relationship history were a Taylor Swift song, it'd be pretty short. He's only had 3 serious girlfriends, and yes, that includes Taylor Swift.
Have you been in love?
I've had love for them, yes. I don't really know if, I feel like love is something that you see yourself with that person forever, and I've never had that.
So, what gives?
Travis in the middle, please.
And Mr. Kelce.
Travis.
He's a cool guy. He's a fun guy. He's a handsome guy. He's a huge guy. He's got it all.
Having it all may have actually been part of the problem when it came to Travis finding love.
I need confidence that she can be in such a limelight an athlete is in. Right. On top of that, be able to be respectful, polite, and classy.
He wants love. He might burn bridges as he goes, but he's definitely on a hunt. He's a hunter.
My name is Travis Kelce. I'm a professional football player for the Kansas City Chiefs.
It's game day, baby.
And I'm looking for love.
Hollywood was quick to latch on to Travis's appeal, casting him in his own dating show, Catching Kelce.
Ah, Miss Maya.
You ain't going back to Kentucky no time soon, huh?
I'm so happy I can't even get
correct. A woman named Maya Benberry won Travis's heart, or so viewers thought. Sources close to TMZ say they only dated for about a month, yet Maya resurfaced once Travis started dating Taylor, accusing him of cheating when they were together.
Like the saying goes, once a cheater, always a cheater. Certain qualities don't change in men.
But sources close to Travis tell us Maya was just trying to get her 15 minutes.
Things got more serious with Kayla Nicole Brown, a sports broadcaster and model. Travis was infatuated and met her after sliding into her DMs.
Travis, right in front of you.
Thanks. Straight ahead, guys. Straight ahead.
Travis and Kayla were on again, off again for about 5 years until they broke up for good in 2022, about a year before Taylor entered the picture.
Once again, there were rumors Travis cheated, rumors he emphatically denies. There were also reports they broke up because Travis forced Nicole to pay for half of everything. Travis denied that as well.
Don't buy into that. She had a very financially stable life and what she was doing in her career. But you got to be crazy if you think I'd never get, like, helped or gave her a couple of dollars to grab some food, or she gave me some money to go get some food. You know what I mean? We were in a relationship for 5 years. Yeah. $100 here and $100 there wasn't even thought about.
A lot of people are like, oh, screwed over his last girlfriend. Well, you know what? People go from people to people till they find the one. That's life.
Travis Kelce is not the biggest star in the NFL, but he does have the biggest personality in the NFL. Trust me, it's the biggest, most overwhelming, overpowering personality of any player in the league. Nobody is more comfortable on the biggest stages in the sport before, during, and after games than Travis Kelce.
As 2023 began, Travis was single and ready to mingle again.
I feel like she's living her own Hallmark movie, you know?
It was clear to me that he liked showing off for her in a great way, that he was fueled by her presence and didn't want to let her down.
End zone, there it is, a touchdown to Kelce.
Popular girl, big star on the football team. It's got to be fun, and maybe that's a rite of passage.
How's it feel that Taylor Swift has finally put you on the map?
In the summer of 2023, Travis Kelce was in hot pursuit of Taylor Swift, but they'd never met. So when her Eras tour landed in Kansas City, he was ready to shoot his shot.
If you're up on Taylor Swift concerts, there are friendship bracelets, and I received a bunch of them being there, but I wanted to give Taylor Swift one with my number on it.
But meeting her that night just wasn't in the cards.
I was disappointed that she doesn't talk before or after her shows because she has to save her voice for the 44 songs that she sings. So I was a little butthurt I didn't get to hand her one of the bracelets I made for her.
A lot of the men that she has dated never put her first and pursued her. So I like that. You know, he's got good homespun values.
Travis wasn't giving up. He talked about his crush to anyone who would listen. And listen they did on Travis's New Heights podcast with brother Jason.
She didn't want to meet me, so I took it personal.
Maybe she just made something up and just didn't want to talk to you.
Damn it.
His friend and sportscaster, Erin Andrews, practically made it a crusade to hook Travis up with Taylor.
Please try our friend Travis. He is fantastic. Take us up on this. Go on a date with this guy. Do it for America.
Well, Taylor got the message, and it worked. She said, quote, "This all started when Travis very adorably put me on blast on his podcast, which I thought was metal as hell."
Taylor and Travis finally met sometime in the summer of 2023. From everything we hear, they were hooked on each other from the get-go. But they kept their budding relationship under wraps. Well, kinda.
Threw the ball in her court, and you know, I told her, you know, maybe I've seen you rock the stage in Arrowhead. You might have to come see me rock the stage in Arrowhead and see which one's a little more lit.
2.5 months after Travis attended her concert, Taylor showed up for her first Chiefs game. So the cat was out of the bag.
Let's do a little detective work here. Travis Kelce, raucous introduction here, as always. And then there's the biggest pop star in the world, Taylor Swift, with Travis's mom, Donna. I think
the secret's out.
Who's she here to see? Mahomes. Lofting end zone. There it is. The touchdown of Kelce.
The Chiefs won. And at a post-game celebration party hosted by Travis, it was clear, game on for both of them.
How's it feel that Taylor Swift has finally put you on the map?
Shout out to Taylor for pulling up. That was pretty ballsy. I just thought it was awesome how everybody in the suite had nothing but great things to say about her. To see the slow motion chest bumps, the high fives with mom. To see how, you know, Chiefs Kingdom was all excited that she was there, that was absolutely hysterical. It was definitely a game I'll remember, that's for damn sure. And then we just slid off in the getaway car at the end.
It was clear to me that he liked showing off for her in a great way, that he was fueled by her presence and didn't want to let her down.
Travis and Taylor's relationship instantly became the biggest story in football. Dare some say, bigger than football.
Six months ago, you're telling me Taylor Swift is going to become the driving force of the Kansas City Chiefs to win the Super Bowl? What? Commit me.
She's living her own Hallmark movie.
Hey.
She wrote a song about how she wasn't the cheerleader, you know, that she was the girl in the bleachers. It's like her song manifested this great twist of fate.
Popular girl, big star on the football team, it's got to be fun. And maybe that's a rite of passage.
I think she's thoroughly enjoyed being the girl on the sidelines and not being the star. This is like exactly where she's supposed to be right now.
And yeah, she's here. Taylor is in the house.
By early November, the Eras Tour was starting back up. Travis traveled to Argentina to catch her show, and Taylor sent him and everyone else a very clear message.
Karma is a queen. Karma takes all my friends to the summit. Karma is the guy on the Chiefs.
How does it feel to officially be the guy on the Chiefs?
You mean Karma?
Karma, that's right.
Yeah, no, I had no clue that, well, I might have had a little bit of a clue.
In the postseason, Travis was on fire.
Mahomes with a good fake down the field. He finds Kelce inside the 30.
And Taylor was scoring on her turf, winning 2 Grammys, including Album of the Year.
Taylor Swift.
Her 4th such award, which broke the all-time record. A week later, Travis and the Chiefs brought it home at the Super Bowl with Taylor right there.
First and goal. Mahomes flings it. It's there! Hartman! Jackpot, Kansas City!
This was the Andy Reid special.
Thank you for coming. Thank you for making it across halfway across the world. You're the best, man.
Oh, my God.
The absolute best. Was it electric?
It was unbelievable.
It's like she has become his driving force, his inspiration, his everything on the football field. So what I thought would be a distraction potentially became an attraction for the Kansas City Chiefs, who took off in and around the Taylor Swift effect.
Travis and Taylor are not just a couple. They're serious. Their families have bonded. They're clearly in love. And this one feels different. And there are reasons why the couple known as Trailer seem like vows may be in their future.
Who do you think the alpha in this relationship is?
I think she's letting him be the alpha.
They can both be alphas in their own lane, and those lanes don't have to intersect and have a collision.
He's not as big as she is, obviously, but in his sport he is, and on his stages he is as an entertainer.
Taylor Swift and Travis Kelce have a unique relationship, one that neither had with any other of their boyfriends and girlfriends. And a lot has to do with the fact they've succeeded in different worlds.
Both of them are in the public eye, of course, but they're in such unrelated fields that if each of them stay passionate about what they're doing, they can both be alphas in their own lane. And those lanes don't have to intersect and have a collision, because they're both so accomplished with what they do that there's no direct competition.
He probably doesn't know anything about the music industry and has no thoughts on it. When you're in the industry, then I could easily see her dating somebody or being asked questions. What do you think about this? What do you think about that person? You know, will this song work? When you're dating somebody outside your industry, it's like, go for it, babe. I have no idea what you're talking about, but I support you.
I think it takes a very particular kind of man to be competent enough to be Taylor Swift's boyfriend. And I think she has found perhaps the perfect match in Travis.
Why is that?
Because I think a lot of men would be insecure or jealous. And the fact that he's already seen such success and in such a totally different venue makes him successful in his own right.
Yet there are still some similarities in their careers that give them a unique connection.
They can immediately relate because she owns her stages, like very few entertainers ever have. And they connected because of their star power, that they could relate to each other on a star level. He's not as big as she is, obviously, but in his sport he is, and on his stages he is as an entertainer.
There's something else. Taylor may be recapturing a part of her youth that she missed. My theory is this. When somebody becomes famous, especially when they're really young, their growth stunts because all of a sudden everybody around them is doing things for them. They're busy, they're performing. I think Taylor Swift never lived the way a high school girl lives, having that kind of fun.
I'm gonna tell you that I'm gonna give you a job right now as a matchmaker. That was perfect. All of her friends come to the games with her, and she's got a sorority going. She's back in college.
And of course, the obvious.
Being hot and handsome and sexy and muscly, that takes a bit of the edge off, right? I'm gonna say sexual chemistry is off the charts. And I like the pursuit, the way he pursued her made her feel safe.
And pursue Taylor Travis did. And that itself proved irresistible for her.
see from Travis's perspective, she's hot, she's beautiful, she's confident, she's everything he may like, and I'm just gonna go for it. Why not?
He checks a lot of boxes. Obviously, he's, you know, charming and good looking and seems to be really funny, but he also really loves his family. He also seems to be a genuinely good person. And I think that's something that Taylor's fans have been hoping for and, you know, hoping that she would find for quite a while.
And just like mom, when she knows her boys had a big battle, she comes bearing gifts. Come on in here, mom. Come on in here, mom. Bob Donna is joining us.
I think that's a rock solid family, the Kelce family. I think Travis has a lot of maturity, and I think that's going to lend a lot to this relationship. So I think Taylor has matured across time, and I think the core family values that you see with the Kelces is going to be a real touchstone for that relationship.
In every relationship, one person usually takes the lead. And when both sides are used to being the center of attention, well, that can get tricky.
Who do you think the alpha in this relationship is?
I think she is letting him be the alpha. You know, you always hear about women being criticized for emasculating the man. But no one gives us the credit when we purposely masculate our man. And oftentimes women consciously do that. And it's a really smart thing to do. And I think she does it. And I think he also really lifts her up.
And maybe it's as simple as this. They are two really accomplished, interesting, fun-loving, good people.
I think that Taylor is just really the perfect girl, in my opinion. I think she's a fabulous daughter. I think she's a really good friend. She is kind of a good girl in the best way.
Here's the thing. Nothing's perfect. Nothing. Fact is, there are speed bumps ahead for Taylor and Travis. Big question, how will they navigate around them? Taylor and Travis are clearly in love, but there are still challenges. For starters, navigating two massive careers.
The biggest risk factor I see is if they both have schedules that are so full that they fight to spend quality time together.
Long-distance relationships, Harvey, they're hard. They don't go to CVS and do the errands. But remember what he said. He said, I like that she's like that. The other ones may have felt competitive and felt inferior.
Travis right here, sir.
There is another challenge, privacy. Something that has proved more than elusive for Taylor since she was a teenager, and something Travis has been experiencing in a big way since he started dating her.
There is no such thing as privacy anymore for them. It does not exist. Having security, having, you know, people that have to be there with you because it is such a scene everywhere you go. So the first thing you have to understand is they have zero privacy.
All eyes are on every move, and everyone seems to have an opinion.
Taylor Swift coming to the games and being, you know, dating Travis put a huge burden on the team. It wasn't anyone's fault. It's just the nature of the whole thing. It's a distraction.
Taylor told Time magazine, I have no awareness of if I'm being shown too much and pissing off a few dads, brads, and chads.
One group that's not complaining? NFL execs.
This year's Super Bowl achieved a new record. More than 123 million people tuned in.
I think it's great to have her a part of it. Obviously, it creates a buzz, and I think that's great for us.
Roger Goodell could not have written a better script if he tried. And if he wrote it in the script and tried to sell it to Hollywood, they would laugh at it. You know, you could see the movie, you know, the world's biggest female star, you know, pop star comes in and you know, falls in love with one of the best tight ends of all time. The NFL has got to be happier than pigs in mud.
And then there's the merch. Sales for Travis's jersey spiked 400% when Taylor came into the picture.
There doesn't seem to be a company that doesn't want Travis as its spokesperson.
Let me be direct. You're watching football wrong.
Can't keep filming these in here, man.
What do you call a guy in face paint who can't find the game? A clown.
I'll bet you that even though his playing career is not as long as her performing career, he will reinvent himself in a way. And, you know, I don't know that he'll ever make the money that she's making, but there are different kinds of currency. And he will be passionate about whatever he does, and that's the kind of currency that will keep him with a good self-image and a good self-esteem that I think will keep them on a level playing field going forward.
And you can't help but wonder, what would happen if the two of them went into business together?
I think they would be extremely successful, and people will love it, but it will affect their marriage. And if you really want to have a peaceful, beautiful marriage for the rest of your life, sometimes you could be more successful as business partners, but I think it makes your marriage more challenging, no matter how successful you are.
What they can do together, get married, and yes, start a family. And if you think the buzz around Taylor and Travis is big now, just wait.
I could see him wanting to get engaged in an Eiffel Tower situation, a private moment, but in the most romantic city on earth.
So are you telling me that TMZ should have a camera at the Eiffel Tower at midnight?
Yes, I do.
It's gonna be the biggest wedding, like, in history, probably. Oh, that kiss. Well, wait for that kiss. It's gonna be insanely beautiful.
Ever since the Super Bowl, the world has become obsessed with not if, but when Taylor and Travis will get engaged.
I believe she's performing in Paris in May. And as much as I love Travis, he is sort of basic in the best kind of way. And I could see him wanting to get engaged in an Eiffel Tower situation, a private moment, but in the most romantic city on earth.
So are you telling me that TMZ should have a camera at the Eiffel Tower at midnight when she's performing?
Yes, I do. But I hope I didn't ruin it for them now.
And there's no doubt about it. The hoopla around a Taylor Travis wedding would be like nothing the world has ever seen.
It's gonna be the biggest wedding like in history, probably. Oh, that kiss, well, wait for that kiss. It's gonna be insanely beautiful.
And assuming they do get married, what's the timeline for having kids?
6 years ago, Taylor had this to say in her Netflix documentary, Miss Americana.
I'm about to be 29.
How do you feel about that?
I mean, yeah, there's a part of me that feels like I'm 57 years old, but then there's a part of me that's like, definitely not ready to have kids, definitely not ready for all this grown-up stuff.
But they're both 34 now, and as they say, the clock is ticking.
I think she's very pragmatic in her choices in life, and like a lot of women in their early 30s, this is the time that you kind of start to think about nesting, getting married, having kids. So I think she found a great guy with probably very strong swimmers, and I look forward to the baby shower.
Can you imagine what kind of children they would have if they had a son? He could probably play in a Super Bowl ultimately and do the halftime show.
From a TMZ perspective, Taylor and Travis have thankfully rejected the celebrity playbook of hiding the fact they're dating and in love. They're embracing it, partying in public, showing PDA for anyone who's watching. It's refreshing and it's real. So don't be surprised if you check out our website in the not too distant future and see a very tall, handsome football star pop the question to a beautiful, talented singer who took over the world.